Terence Conran says that a living room should be that place that we feel totally at ease and a temple of our soul. Welcome to the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Today's episode is dedicated to living rooms, which is a focal point in a whole house. Joining us today on set is Becca Ainebiona, who is a furniture expert and is going to guide us on exploring the essence of living rooms. Without further ado, let us dive into the show. Does a style determine the type of furniture they have in their living rooms?
Yeah, when it comes to the style of a living room, it's actually determined by the design of the living room. Because as we said earlier, if the design is rectangular, for example, then it dictates that most likely you'll have maybe an L-shaped style of your living room with chairs maybe in an L shape, so that you have more view of whatever other areas you have of your living room. If the living room shape or design is for example, circular, then it dictates that you also look for a sofa that is designed in a circular way shape, so that your shape of your living room and the shape of your sofa, they are matching. If the design of your living room is triangular, then an L-shape also would, an L-shaped sofa would be a good idea. Now we have a problem. Most people overcrowd their living rooms. I had a client, very big client, very rich, very exposed, even he lived in the UK. I will not mention his name for security reasons. But when we took furniture to his home, he said, I want, it's like, how can I call it, like a conference home, hall. With the sofas lined in the same line, in another line, in another line. Yeah, but I told him, sir, this is not good. Can you allow me and I organize this? So I gave him an option of organizing it in two different areas. Having a living room divided into two parts. And at the end of the day, he appreciated that the idea he had was not good for his for his living room, because when you visit some of these families, like in the Arabic countries, you find that the living room is like a football football pitch, and because of the loyal nature, the furniture is lined up in one direction, another direction, another direction. But you lose the beauty of your living room, where the shape is not suitable for such a kind of setting. Try and be creative.
Now,
in design of sofas and furnitures now, we have simplified it in a way that we have different shapes to fit different environments.
Under shapes, under different shapes, fitting different environment. I'm coming when I have maybe an oval sitting room. Do you import your furniture, or you design the furniture according to my shape or the sitting room?
We import designs for different areas.
Okay.
And we have at the back of our mind that our customers are not going to have the same shapes, same designs of living rooms. So within our portfolio, you'll find that we have an oval sofa, we have a rectangular sofa like these old designs. Mm. We have contemporary sofas or contemporary designs that will fit exactly in the environment that you want.
What are the contemporary sofas, for instance?
Contemporary sofas, you see, contemporary sofas are modern sofas with modern shapes.
Can you elaborate more about that?
It's contemporary in terms of usability, functionality, and shape. For example,
yes,
we have recliners. Those are contemporary designs.
Okay, what are the recliners?
Recliners, these are sofas that you can actually sit in like this one.
Yes.
This is a recliner, and be able to push it on the side and even raise your legs, and you are able to be comfortable in your living room. These are recliners. This one is a recliner.
Mm.
So you can change it into any kind of position you want. We have 360 degrees sofas.
What is a 360?
That means you can rotate
in it.
In it, yes.
Yes.
So it helps you now to view your living room the way all
from
parts
all
of your living
room.
Exactly. Or talk to anybody in your living room freely and conversing together.
Mm.
So the shape of your living room influences the design. The design of your living room should influence the kind of sofa or setting you have for your house.
I've seen some sofas that at the same time can act as a bed.
Yeah, sofa beds.
Yes.
Yeah.
Do you have them?
Yes, we have sofa beds. We have all kind of sofas.
What category do they fall in?
They would fall in the modern sofas.
Mm.
Because you see, you are doing what we call multifunctioning.
Mm.
You have, it's a sofa, it's a bed, it's a storage.
Mm.
It also has a storage.
Okay.
Yeah. So these are kind of the features that when you are buying, depending on where you put that particular sofa, you need to put those into consideration. And many people don't do that.
Mm.
You find that the sitting room is big, disorganized, with a lot of furniture. Yet when you put one sofa or two, it would make a very huge difference.
Now I need
of
to know.
Of course, it is determined by the families. Our families here are big families, and therefore, the minimum African family we are looking at 7-seaters, 5-seaters. But as we develop in layout of living rooms, it is important that you have more space to move around for functionality, and little space for the furnitures.
You talked about families. Does a family determine what furniture you should have in my living room?
Yes, absolutely, yes. Because you see, in a family, you have so many people of different ages and categories. You have ladies, you have young children. They need furniture also. So like here, I advise that a living room must have those categories of what? Of sofas.
Mm.
Children should not just run and go into big sofas which are supposed to be reserved for guests. Rather, you create a space for them where you can put things like stools, modern stools.
Mm.
You can put you can put other kind of furniture specifically designed for children, so that even in their own space, they are what? They are happy. I usually give my clients an example of a dining.
Mm.
If you have a big dining space, get maybe a 6-seater, have it in your home, and also create a small space for a 4-seater for the children, so that maybe when you have so many people, the big guests can be on the 6-seater, and the children and the other family members can be on the 4-seater. But you are living together in the same dining hall if you have a space for the dining. big dining space.
You talked about children. How can we maintain the furniture in our homes?
Very good. This is a very good question.
Thank you.
Most people come and tell me, Mr. Baker, I'm not going to buy these big, beautiful sofas when I have children. Children appreciate everything. When you tell children that this is a very beautiful sofa, you need to keep it very well, very nicely, they will learn to keep it. And they will come and sit and use those spaces very well and keep them neat. But that aside, we provide cleaning services to maintain the sofas clean. When you buy our sofa and you have a problem with cleaning, we can also give you sofa cleaning materials, which you can use even yourself and do it at home and maintain your sofa. Because you see, most people, when they are buying, they don't look at the cost of maintenance. They think when you have bought something, that is all. To keep the product live longer, you have to service it. You have to maintain it. And that small maintenance will keep your sofa in a very good shape. We give after-sales support services for all our products. When you buy a product from us and you get a problem with that, we give you after-sales support service.
Let's talk about an open living.
Yes.
In that case, how do I assemble my furniture to have a beautiful living room?
You see, open living is actually now modern space. People like to be in their living rooms. You see the dining, you see the kitchen, you see how they are serving the food. This is beautiful. So to make sure that you have a good space, I would always advise my clients, start with the architect. When the architect is doing for you a plan for your house, involve an interior designer. Involve an expert. Yes.
At that stage?
Yes. You see, in computer, there is something called garbage in, garbage out.
True.
So when you put in garbage, automatically you can't make those collections. So I always advise our clients that as you are designing your house, involve all the experts that are necessary, even the outdoor. If you have been to our basement down there, we have outdoor living. People want to spend their time outside also.
Okay.
And therefore, you create an environment outside as if you are in the living inside. So this is a modern way of how people should appreciate their homes and be able to make their homes creative and be functional in all the circumstances. Yeah.
Construction trends have changed,
yeah.
Baker.
Yes.
How can you advise someone who had a living room 20 years back to match up the standard living room that we are having now in modern days?
Very important question. And that is the Italian way of doing things. In fact, Italians are not building new houses. When he has a house of his grandfather or a bed of his grandfather, it is the one that he changes to look new, to look beautiful, to look innovative. And most likely we are losing a point, some of us, in those areas. But all designs can be modern designs. It just requires some innovation, it requires some creativity. So we can actually modify, just a little modification of your living room, if it was looking a certain way, and you'll be surprised. I think you have been on the Google where you see before
and
and after.
Yeah.
We can do exactly that, and you'll be surprised that actually you're just adding value to what you have, getting the modern functionality using the old old growth, if I can say.
So how can you have a cluttered home look more spacious?
That's very specific, very, very big English. Maybe you can also make it easier for our viewers.
Yeah, at times we find you enter a room and you find when it's so congested.
Ah, congested, okay.
Now, how can we make it look more spacious?
As I said earlier, most people congest their environments and they don't mind about the space that should be very useful, functional, you know? So, it's about changing a setting or a style that will create the new environment that you didn't have in your house before. And you, let me tell you, you need an expert like us to view your place and tell you, say, okay, suppose we remove this sofa and we put it in another place, in another corner. Suppose we put here a console.
Yes.
Not a sofa. You get it? And in a minute, your home will change. You'll like it much better.
Okay.
Without spending even a penny, we can just use what is available. And just by changing the setting, by changing the style, by changing the shape, by matching the colors together, you have something completely different.
With our economy that is actually getting out of hand, how can a low-income earner have a beautiful living home?
Number one, come to me. Be able to enjoy international modern products. You don't need to spend all the money at a go. You can start with the 20%. So if, for example, a sofa is 5 million Uganda shillings, 20% is 1 million. Can start with 20%, pay slowly.
I want to talk about the budget. What is the tentative budget one must have to work with or to get a beautiful living room? In your own experience.
Now, a living room, you need about minimum five items in your living room.
Which ones?
Minimum five items. A sofa.
Yes.
And a sofa, depending on the size of the living room, can be even one sofa or two sofas. Maybe a two-seater and a single-seater. And you have a living room for a sofa. You need a coffee table like this one. You need a console, maybe with a mirror, to be able to help you when you are dressing, or whatever.
I can leave a console maybe.
Even you can leave a console and leave the mirror.
Because I may have that in my bedroom.
Exactly. The third item you need is a rug.
There's
a way the rug that, that's a carpet down there, like this one here. It changes the environment. It keeps your place clean. And some deco.
People
don't
where?
Understand deco. People actually in this country don't understand deco. Very important. It's like having a tire without buying tires, and maybe the engine is not there. You need that software.
Becca, don't let my people go and get drapings and start putting in their living rooms.
No. We have deco, and the deco can be in so many forms.
Okay.
It can be figurines. It can be a picture. Like a wall art,
yes.
It can be a flower vase, it can be wall hangings, it can be wall mirrors, it could be all kind of shapes. If you have been to one of our deco room areas down there, we are importing shapes, fruit shapes, like orange,
yes.
From Netherlands. But when you look at it, it is it's made of wood, but it looks beautiful.
True.
So those small decors make a difference in your living room. Mm. So you shouldn't miss a sofa, you shouldn't miss a rug, you shouldn't miss a coffee table, you shouldn't miss a console, you shouldn't miss a decor to complement those things in your living room. Mm. So if you don't have those, they are not just there.
While creating a living room design that incorporates the current trends, it is important to create an inviting, pleasing, and functional space. While you have received all the advices from the experts on the Homes and Construction show, ultimately, the decision for what works in your house is entirely yours. This is how we are ending our show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Thank you for being with us. Until next time, bye-bye.